Namaste. In today's video, I'll discuss certain combinations related to late marriage. Whenever the marriage doesn't happen on time, there is a panic or an anxiety that sets in both in the boy and the girl as well as the parents. So I'm going to give you certain combinations which indicate delay in marriage and not denial of marriage. If you have these combinations in the horoscope, essentially what it means is the marriage is going to be delayed. Now what does it mean when we say delay in marriage? If you look at the statistics of the average marriage year for both male and female horoscopes, what we will find is in the last 20 years, that is from 2000 to 2020, the average marriage age for males has been 26-27 years and for females has been 23 and 24 years. This is with reference to India. So when we say delay in marriage, you roughly add about 5 years extra. Depending on the number of combinations that are present, this 5 will stretch up to 10 years. So let's go about analyzing each of these combinations. Now we all know when we look at marriage, we have to look at certain houses and certain planets. So we look at the 7th house from Lagna, we look at the 7th house from Chandra. The second set we look at is the 7th Lord from Lagna, the 7th Lord from Chandra Lagna, and finally the Karaka. So when we look at a male horoscope, the Karaka for male horoscope is Venus, and when we look at it from a female horoscope, the Karaka is Ketu. Now with this understanding, I will give you certain combinations which will indicate delay in marriage, that is late marriages. Combination number one, if Jupiter, Guru, is present in the 7th house, in Saptamadhyaya, in the Saptamasthana, then delay in marriage is indicated. For any horoscope, boy or girl, if Jupiter is in the 7th house, then delay is indicated. Now there are certain exceptions. Let's look at what these exceptions are. If Jupiter owns the 5th or the 9th house, then this combination is cancelled. If Jupiter occupies Libra, then this combination is cancelled. If Jupiter is in a quadrant from Moon, then also this combination gets cancelled. We'll go to the next combination. Saturn, if it is present in the 7th house, it also indicates delay in marriage. In addition, it will also indicate that the spouse, male or female, whatever may be the case, would be a little senior as compared to the average marriageable grouping. Then there are certain exceptions here. If Saturn is a Yoga Karaka, then this combination is negated. If Saturn owns 4th and 5th houses, that means if your Lagna is Tula, then this combination does not exist. If Saturn owns 9th and 10th houses, that is when your Lagna is Vrishabha or Taurus, then this combination gets negated. If Saturn is in Pisces, that is, if it is Kanya Lagna and the 7th house happens to be Pisces and Saturn is in Pisces, then this combination is again negated. Let's look at the third combination. If the seventh lord is in a dustana from the seventh house, then late marriage is indicated. What does it mean? If the seventh lord is in the 12th house, if seventh lord is in the second house, or if seventh lord is in the sixth house, then late marriage is indicated. Again, there is an exception here. If Jupiter is aspecting the seventh lord, not a conjunction, if Jupiter is aspecting the seventh lord, then this combination gets negated. Fourth, if the seventh lord is either with Jupiter or Saturn, then delay in marriage is indicated. Fifth, if the Karaka is under the influence of Jupiter or Saturn, then delay in marriage is indicated. What does it mean, Karaka? For male horoscopes, the Karaka is Venus, and for female horoscopes, the Karaka is Ketu. If Ketu or Venus, depending on whichever is the Karaka, is under the influence of Jupiter or Saturn. So when I say influence, it either means conjunction or an aspect. Even special aspects are included. Then delay of marriage is indicated. Sixth combination. If again the Karaka is receiving a 10th aspect of Saturn and aspected by Mars as well, then delay in marriage is indicated. Next combination, seventh one. Now, certain pairing of planets, if present in the seventh house, also indicates delay in marriage. Now, which are these pairings? If Mars and Sun are together in the seventh house, or if Mars and Moon are together in the seventh house, then delay of marriage is indicated. Similarly, if Rahu and Venus, especially for Ben, if Rahu and Venus are present in the seventh house, delay in marriage is taken place. If Ketu and Jupiter is present again in a similar situation, delay in marriage is indicated. In fact, in these two combinations, Rahu Shukra and Ketu Guru, in these two combinations, the marriage will also not be very comfortable. After the marriage happens, the married life will also not be very comfortable. So they will have to resort to a lot of remedial measures. Finally, the ninth combination. If Mars is with the Karaka, that is, if Mars is with Venus in a male horoscope, or if Mars is with Ketu in a female horoscope, then also delay in marriage is indicated. I hope this video was very helpful for you. Take a look at your respective horoscope and see if this combination is present. If this combination is present, then you don't have to unnecessarily worry whether you have the positive points for marriage or not. It's just that there would be a delay in marriage. The marriage is going to happen, but there is going to be a delay in marriage. Now, what I have given you is purely from a Rashi chart. Now, there are very different combinations that are available for a Navamsha chart as well. And there are certain combinations that are applicable with when a particular type of Kuja Dosha exists. This will also result in late marriages. These I will cover in the coming videos. If you like this video, please like this or share your comments below. If you want me to speak on a particular topic, don't hesitate. Leave a comment below and I will try to cover that as well. Namaste.